When I was in high school, I competed in a competition called Sterling Scholar in the math category. I advanced to the final round, but I was surprised when the interviewers asked me only this one question. The problem goes like this. There are three prisoners who are given a chance to win a game for their freedom. A blue or red hat will be placed on each of their heads. Each prisoner can't see their own hat, but they can see the other two prisoners' hats. The colors of each hat will be determined by fair coin flips, so each color is equally likely. The prisoners all win the game if at least one of them guesses their own hat color correctly without any incorrect guesses being made. If even one of them guesses incorrectly, then all of the prisoners will lose. The prisoners can coordinate a strategy before the game starts, but once the hats are placed, there is no communication of any kind. The prisoners won't even know if anyone else has guessed. So what strategy will give the prisoners the greatest chance of winning this game? You can pause the video here if you want to think about it. When I was first asked this question, I figured that the more prisoners guess, the worse the outcome will be. For example, if one prisoner guesses, they have a 50-50 chance of guessing correctly. But for two prisoners to both guess correctly, that's like guessing two coin flips, which has probably 1/4. So my first thought was that the prisoners should just pick one person to make a guess and have the other two remain silent. This gives them a 50-50 chance of winning the game. I figured there must be another better option, since this was the only question the interviewers were asking me during our 10-minute interview, but it also seems strange to me that it would be possible to do any better than that. Each prisoner only sees the other two hat colors, which are selected independently of their own hat. So how could that provide any extra information to improve the odds? The trick to this problem is that the prisoners don't have to decide in advance who will guess. They can each observe the other two hat colors and then decide if they will guess or not. Let's imagine what a prisoner sees when the game starts. They could see two matching hats or two different hats. If they see two different hats, either a blue and a red or a red and a blue, then it's hard to say what the prisoner should guess. So maybe it's best not to guess in this case. But what if a prisoner sees two identical colors, both blue or both red? Should the prisoner guess that they also have that same color or that they have the other color? To have the same color, that would mean all three of them have the same color, either all blue or all red. That happens in 2 out of the 8 possible cases, or 1/4 of the time. Otherwise, there will be two hats of one color and one hat of the other. So let's try this strategy. If a prisoner sees two hats of the same color, then they guess that their hat is the other color. If a prisoner sees two different colors, they just won't guess. With this strategy, what happens if all the hats are blue? Every prisoner sees two blue hats and guesses that their own hat is red. All three of them guessed incorrectly and they lose the game. The same principle applies if all the hats are red. But what if there are two blue hats and one red hat? In this case, only one prisoner sees two matching blue hats. This prisoner guesses that they have a red hat and they are correct. The prisoners win the game, and they will win in the remaining 6 out of 8 cases, or 75% of the time. This strategy does much better than a 50-50 guess. How on earth did this strategy work? Each prisoner only sees information that is independent of their own hat color, so each guess is a 50-50 guess. The idea is that the prisoners were able to bunch up their possible failures and spread out their possible successes. Note in our chart, the prisoners make a total of 6 correct guesses and 6 incorrect guesses among all the possible outcomes. But the reason they have the advantage is that they have bunched up their incorrect guesses to happen 3 at a time, while their correct guesses happen 1 at a time. So their 6 correct guesses fill up 6 different outcomes, and their 6 incorrect guesses fill up only 2 possible outcomes. Each individual guess is a 50-50 chance, but the team wins 75% of the time. That's pretty amazing. Could there be a better strategy than this? Well, there must be an equal number of correct and incorrect guesses among all the possible outcomes. If the prisoners can win in 7 of the 8 cases, then that's at least 7 successes, but there's no way to put 7 incorrect guesses in the one remaining case. Even if they all guess incorrectly, that's only 3 incorrect guesses. So the strategy we found is the best possible strategy. Even though I didn't solve this problem in my interview, I couldn't help but be amazed by its solution. What do you think happens to the optimal probability of winning if there are more than 3 prisoners? Let us know your ideas in the comments. Thanks for watching, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time.